stressed out, my girl got the flat ass. Shorty man pulling her hair out.
Come to the block in a brand new band. Knowing that me and that nigga ain't friends. Yo, what I did was whack, but you don't get a nigga back like that.
Yeah.
Lost in the round with him up in these streets.
Yeah.
Knowing that me and that nigga got beats.
Hey. Welcome to End Times Girls Club. There's a couple things I want to talk about tonight. Mostly dealing with disaster communication. Now, I'm fairly certain that the end times are near. And I mean near. So, what are we going to do? How are we going to stay in touch with people? The people who are still alive? How are you going to find out if your family or friends are still alive? Well, let's think about it this way. What networks are you dependent on that may fail you? I know for sure that you won't be able to count on the internet. You won't be able to count on connecting to the internet, even if the internet is still up in a lot of places. If there are servers running in different parts of the world, it doesn't help you if there's been a major nuclear attack or locusts or pestilence or, you know, if one part of the system fails, you probably can't get online. Now, okay, internet, that's one system that we're dependent on. How do we connect to it usually? Smartphones. What else do smartphones connect to? 3G. And GSM, meaning calls that you make. Now, personally, I'm in AT&T, and AT&T cells, which give me service in different areas, run on power. So let's say that there's a huge storm in New York City. Sound familiar? Yeah. So there's a huge storm. We lose power, which means the servers are down, which means there's no internet, which means the cell towers are down, which means can't make calls, can't reach anybody. How are we going to communicate? How are we going to find out what's going on? Well, you could try to tune into the radio, but AM, FM radio stations, which might be reporting news, are probably going to be down in our area. Maybe further away, they'll still be working. So, and AM and FM signals travel pretty far, so you could maybe tune into a station that's still working. But maybe not. And AM and FM radio transmitters take up a lot of power, so you're gonna probably not be able to hear any radio. But maybe police and fire radio is still working. Maybe there's been a flood, and so the power is totally screwed up where you are, but cell towers somehow are still up. Or maybe cell towers are down, but, you know, internet is still on. You have to think about which systems you're connected to and how you can be independent of those systems if any of them fail you. It's likely that a failure of cell service and internet service will happen at the same time if there's major power failures, but what if there's been a nuclear attack and that'll knock out a lot of electromagnetic transmissions, so all radio frequencies, all cell transmissions, all Wi-Fi and internet and electricity. But there's still satellites out there sending down GPS, so maybe your phone's GPS transmitter or receiver can still locate you. If you're lost, you might still be able to use your phone for GPS. But let's say that, well, consider this, however. Let's say AT&T is down, but Singular is still up. Or AT&T is up and Verizon is down, but you're on Verizon. What if, picture this, what if you're a Verizon customer and all the Verizon cells got knocked out, but AT&T was a little luckier and still has service? Or what if AT&T and Verizon are down, but someone has set up a hacker network, a small cell that you could get onto to make calls or get information? If you have your normal cell phone, like me, and you have a plan with Verizon or AT&T, you won't be able to get onto that pop-up network because your phone is locked to your network. Doesn't it make sense then to have a cell phone that's more adapted to whatever is working? I think so. This is why I advise, and I'm going to show you how, to jailbreak your phone. I'm just going to show you how I'm going to do it to mine, because I don't know what kind of phone you have, but any kind of phone can be jailbroken, and you just pretty much have to Google search it. So I did that. I Google searched how to jailbreak my iPhone 4S, and I found that you basically download and run this program on your phone, and everything should still work. And then if it doesn't, you can just update. You can just, you know, restore it to your Apple, to your iOS, and go back and get rid of the jailbreaking. But once it's jailbroken, you can get apps from anywhere. You can run Android or Apple software, and you can get onto any unregistered or potentially illegal cell network. So, let's see. I'm gonna show you how I did it to my phone.